So let's take a look at doing some basic page layout using the latest version of Pages, version 6.2. So in the templates you can see near the bottom some examples of some layouts. So let's say you wanted to do something like this but starting from scratch. So let's start with blank and we have our Pages document here. Now the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go into Document and then turn off Document Body. And that will convert it to a page layout document. Now we're going to go under View and Show Rulers. So now we can see what we've got here. Let's expand the window a little bit so we can see that we've got the edges. And it's an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper, which is what we want. We want to add some guides so we can see where we're doing layout. So we're going to do half inch margin. So I'm going to add a half inch here on the left. And it's hard to get it perfect, but you can. And a half inch here on the right. Same thing on the top. Adding guides like this is going to make it much easier to do what we need. And we're going to do a two column layout here. So a two column layout would put the middle at 4.25 here. So let's say we'll do 4.1 for the side, the right side of the left column. And we will do 4.4 for the right side there. So now we've got everything set. So we can start our layout. Let's start with the headline at the top of this newsletter. Going to hit text for a text box. Going to snap this here to the guide, stretch it across, and type some text. I'm going to select it all and then go to Format and I'm going to set the style to Title. It's important to use styles for something like this because if we want to change, say, the font of all the headlines throughout our newsletter, if they're all set to one style, then we can do that very easily. Now to get it just right, I'm going to center it and I'm going to use Command Plus and Command Minus to change the font size. So I'm going to get it just the right size there so it fits across. Now another thing I want to do is I want to go to a range here and set the text wrapping to none because I'm going to custom place everything here so I don't want text wrapping to get in the way. I'm going to shrink this a little bit here and I'm ready to add some more text. I'll add another text box and I'll stick this here on the left and let's have it go down about here. Text wrapping to none. Let's insert some text here. I have a little widget here that'll give me some sample text. So we've got some sample text and you can see it fills the space and then some. So it goes all the way down to here. Let's add even more text. Great. So now I want it to wrap over here, but I want to put a photo here. So let's drag a photo in. I just dragged and dropped it from the Finder. I'm going to shrink it down and I'm going to style it with a little bit of a border, something like that. And I'm going to shrink it so it fits within the guides here and kind of align it towards the top. I'm also going to change the arrangement for this to none so I can move it close to the top here. And then let me kind of align these. You see how it kind of snaps to each other there. That's great. I'm going to put a caption under this. So let's put another text box. Also set the alignment, the arrangement to nothing there so nothing wraps. So a little picture caption. Turns out there is a default caption style. I'll use that. And I'll use that for all my captions. I'll align that there to the top. And maybe to be nice, I'll center it there. Now I want this to wrap underneath. So I'm going to put another text box here and set it up. And now I need to link these two. So what I'm going to do is select both of them. So I select the first one, Command select the second one. And you can see I've got these dots here at the top. So I'll click on this first dot and I'm going to have to Command click again on this here to select it. And I'll click on the second dot. 1 and 2, they're both green, so they wrap. So I can now shrink this here to get it to fit. So let's say I want it to go to about here. So that looks good. Let's do another headline. To make it easier to do things, I'm going to option drag things like headlines here. So I can just copy by option dragging. So I'll copy that. More text there. It's to make that smaller. I'm going to Command minus to make that fit. That looks good. Shrink this up a bit. Let's create another text box. Stick it down here right underneath. Set that arrangement to none. And let's insert some text in here. Do some more sample text. And I'm going to option drag to copy this. Now what I want to do is I want to clear this out. I'm going to click on that dot there at the top, command click here to select it, and then click there. And now this flows from one to the other. I'm also going to bring in another image here, drop that in, shrink that down, and stick that here. And I can play with the arrangement for that as well, but I'll just leave it automatic. So that looks really nice. I'm going to create a second page now. So let's turn on thumbnail so I can see this here. And I'm going to insert a page. And unfortunately with the second page here I have to set the guides again. So I'm going to go in here and set those same guides. Now I'll add a text box here so I can continue the articles from the previous page. Set the arrangement to none. And I can click here on the top and it'll continue from this article. I don't want it to continue from that article, so I'm going to click it again and I'll pick the right color there and it continues from the first article. And what would be nice is if I can actually put something kind of like that caption where I just put a piece of text here and say like, you know, big headline continued. And then maybe I'll create my own format here. So let's make this bold and something like that and just some basics like that. And I'll create a new style here. Call it continued. And then I could use that as well here. So I'll option drag up here. Shrink this column and say continued. Next page. Like that. I'll do one of these down here as well. And I will select these both, option drag over here. I only selected one. There we go. And I will have this one continued. So small headline. Headline continued. And of course these could fill up the rest of the page there. So you get the basic idea of how to do this. The nice thing with these headlines and with the captions and everything being the same style is now I could go and say, oh, I don't want those to be you know, that font. I want it to be another font. And then I could update the style and you could see it updated it down here. So it's a nice way to do newsletters pretty quick. Didn't take me that long. And you could do a lot with them and put another half hour into this and you can perfect it and get it looking just like you want.